Our lab focuses on orthopedic research. So what we're trying to do is, one, understand how osteoarthritis, a very debilitating disease, develops and how we can diagnose it, and then how we can treat it. And so we come up with, and in that scheme, we come up with ways to try to diagnose the disease better, ways to better understand how the tissues in the joint react and are contribute to the development of osteoarthritis. And then we come up with ways to test and develop new treatment strategies for osteoarthritis. Whenever you start to get osteoarthritis, that tissue gets worn away. And as that tissue gets worn away, you start getting pain and inflammation. And so what that means is that your joint hurts, right? And as your joint hurts, you start to use it less. And the problem with using your joint less is that cartilage doesn't have a blood supply. The only way it gets nutrients to the cells is through joint movement, right? And so therefore, you already have a damaged tissue that, as you use it, gets damaged more. And if you use it less, the cells start to starve and it gets damaged and it progresses as well. And so what you're doing is basically what you end up with is bone on bone, and that is very painful.
What about it now interests you the most?
One, it's something that affects pretty much everybody. Everybody is probably going to develop some form of osteoarthritis if they get old enough. And so it is a very real, very debilitating problem. So I like the idea that I can help affect people's lives. It's also a very challenging problem. People have been focused on this for a very long time, and we still do not have a good way to diagnose the disease before it's already at the reversible stage. So that's a very intriguing challenge to me.
What would you say is most satisfying about the work that you do, both as a teacher and as a researcher?
As a teacher, I think it's watching the students progress and understand more and more how to do research, how to develop a hypothesis, how to then take their data and apply it to a clinical situation, or to apply it to what else is out there in the literature, and then take that and develop another hypothesis, and watching them progress as a researcher and understand more and more the process to go through and actually do research. And then as a researcher, it's just hitting that aha moment where one of your ideas actually works. Because in research, you have 1,000 ideas, thousands and thousands of ideas, and like with anything, they don't all pan out. But you gotta look. We have a very collaborative and helpful environment. So we all support each other. We all are working on each other's projects. We all carry the load of everybody. So we're kind of like a research consortium, you could almost say, where if somebody needs help, there's always somebody there to help them.
Did you seriously consider any other careers before you decided to do research?
I consider being a vet. That was one of the things I considered for quite a few years. But research is what really drew my attention, and I really enjoyed being in the lab, and I've always enjoyed science, and so that definitely was my draw.
Studying osteoarthritis drew Stoker's attention because of his own knee injuries. He advises research students to find a topic that appeals to them as well.
Find a lab where you like the people, and find a disease that you're actually interested in. We'll be right back.